combat. Triss is very good at magic. Dandelion is very good at development, and Yarvin's medium at all of them. So, and what I mean by being very good, you can put that over there. Geralt, for example, can take 3 leads, which is what you need to get proof. So he needs 3 of those to make 1 combat proof. Triss does the same for magic, and Dandelion does the same for diplomacy. Yarvin requires 5 to get 1, but you require 5 to get 1 for all of them. If Dandelion were to try and get a combat proof, you would have to get 7. So they are highly focused, and then the other ones are really a lot more difficult to get, but you can do all of them at the same point. So for the sake of the demo, you start off with 2 investigation of the 2 colors you're going for, so you're going for combat and diplomacy. And that is going to make it so everybody has to ultimately obtain 6 leads to turn in their quest. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So, how you go about gathering leads is that there is a total of 5 different actions you can take. Those actions are to travel, investigate, develop, rest, and then there's one that's unique to each of you, which I'll get into a little later. Travel is mostly self-explanatory. When you move to a new location on the board, you are traveling, and then you get to perform, or you get to either take a lead of either color, so it's a red or purple. So when you enter a new town, you get more information, basically. So this is a red or a purple. This is blue. This is all 3. And this is both a purple and a red. To investigate, there are 3 different investigation decks. Again, they are color-coded for combat, magic, and diplomacy. In here, you can gather leads at a much quicker rate than just moving around the board. However, there are setback cards in here as well. So you, it's a risk-reward kind of thing. So you could be having a really good run of getting a bunch of good cards, and then you hit a wall. Develop, there is a deck of cards with your face on them in front of you. You would draw the top 2 of those, pick one, and discard the other. These cards contain items, spells, things that make your character better when you're ultimately trying to resolve combat. And rest is mostly self-explanatory as well. When you have wounds, you go rest, and then you get to take those off your character sheet. That's the overall basics. I'll let Geralt take his first 2 actions, and then I'll explain how obstacles work.
Okay.
So you can travel, develop, or investigate.
I will travel.
All right.
To Arkaroth.
That you would like a red one?
Yes.
And what else would you like to do?
And use these to mark...
Yeah, on the hearts.
Can you take the same action twice, or...
No, you cannot.
Then I will... develop.
Draw 2, pick 1. I like your necklace, that's really pretty. Got it here a number of years ago.
The other goes on the bottom?
Yep.
Okay.
All right, and now it goes of your obstacles. So in each of the 6 regions, there are a variety of different things that can sort of slow you down. So there are monsters and foul fates. To know which region you are in is the color of the banner of the location you're standing on. So these are all the silver regions. These are the purple, green, yellow, blue, and orange. Foul Fate, which are these tokens, is just a deck of bad things that can potentially happen. So you get the plague, or bandits come and take your money, or that kind of thing. So you're in the Silver Region, so you are going to have to fight a monster.
Okay.
And you are going to fight a ghoul. You're going to roll your hero dice and these battle dice. You're rolling all 6. You're trying to roll 3 swords.
Okay.
And that's ultimately what you're going for.
For these abilities where I can spend things, do I have anything to spend at this point?
You actually, you're supposed to start with 1 on your potion.
Okay.
That you started out with for the sake of the demo. So you're looking for 3 swords. And you didn't roll any of them.
That's not
so
good.
You have the medallion that allows you to reroll all 3 of your witcher, or all 3 of your hero die, which are the red die.
Yeah, might as well, since... It's probably gonna be incredibly unlikely.
And
sword. Okay, well that worked.
And this monster dies, so you receive one red lead for killing it.
Oh, great.
And that concludes your turn. So now it's your turn.
Travel to Oxenford.
All right, and you get a blue lead, I assume, for going there.
And I will investigate.
All right. Receive one red investigation token and advance the war track and discard one of your other investigation cards. As a setback card, all you're going to get is a red token because you don't have any other investigation cards. To briefly explain how that works, much of the magic deck has a bunch of cards that have traits on them, and they tear off of each other. So this would be bad if you had a couple that were tearing off of one another and you had to discard it. So, and I will advance the war track, which just means that I place a new obstacle in that area. So now you're going to have to decide whether or not you want to suffer a foul fate or fight a monster. What would you like to do?
Let's do a foul fate.
All right, so foul fate is foul creature. Place one silver monster face up in your region. So it is a harpy, which requires 3 swords and 3 shields. So now that is just hanging out in your area, and it is now Dandelion's turn. In the red area.
So anybody who goes there has to deal with it?
At the end of their turn.
That's not fair. Yeah.
So what do we need to beat it again?
3 swords and 3 swords to kill it and 3 shields to defend against its attack.
Okay. So you could kill it and still get hit by it. Okay.
But there's nothing there.
Is one, and then you can get a purple. And what else would you like to do?
Now, I could also travel again and get a... I can't do that.
You can't travel more than one. You can't perform the same action twice in a turn.
Well, it says I can move one or two routes.
All right, so how that works is when you move 2 routes, so this would be 1, and then to go here would be 2, but when you are doing that, you're rushing, so you'll have to suffer a foul fate.
When do I suffer the foul fate?
Immediately.
Before I get the...
Before you would get that lead, because you don't get 2, you have skipped the one in the middle.
So I don't get 1. I don't even get 1.
You wouldn't
even get 2.
Yeah.
It's really like a
problem.
All right, well, I'll just take it.
Okay. All right.
And
how much longer do you have to wait for the next demo?
We just started, so probably like 20 minutes.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
I will investigate.
All right.
So we get the best combat.
Investigate. You get 1 purple lead. You have a task to go to card. Reward, receive 1 purple lead and draw a good fortune card. Keep this card until this task is resolved. So it's like a side quest, and it's telling you to actually go to this location where you were trying to go before. So on your next turn, you can travel again, go here, gain a lead and a good fortune card. And you are in the silver region, and there's nothing in there right now, so I will advance the war track, which will spawn this for a future turn. Take your turn, I will quickly explain the 5th action that I've been avoiding. So all of you have that 5th action that sort of charges your ability to use your development cards. So for Geralt, it is a action called Brew. So he's brewing his potions and he places a common marker on there to have them ready. You are the only person who has to declare before you roll that you're going to use that potion, so you can't use it after.
Okay.
Tris prepares spells, so you charge your spells to have them at the ready when you want to use them. Dandelion saves, so you get 2 points. Thematically, you don't actually fight anything because you're a bard, so you're paying off your friends to get to come and fight for you. So as a micro action, what you can do is anytime that you have money, you can trade that into me, and I will give you these to charge your abilities. Make sense? Did you start with a gold or lose it? Okay, then, somehow I always manage to do that. I'm like trying to. Alright. And then, Yarquin, yours is very special because you have the ability called Command, so you have 4 minions. Companions, I call them minions. You have 4 companions. They each have a different ability. You get to activate 2 of them. So this is receive one gold. You can place one common marker on one of your skills. That removes one foul fate or one monster from the region you are in to an adjacent location, and exchange any lead of one color for a different color. For the sake of the demo, you all started with your abilities charged so that if you needed to use them, you could. He's the only one who might actually want to do the other actions, which is why I explained it in that order. That's all.
So that would be the command here.
What is the gold used for?
The gold is used for some of your foul fate will ask you to spend them. Other cards will require you to spend
gotcha.
Them. You do end up using it. Dandelion uses it probably more than anybody else. You also have to use it to travel to certain locations.
So to go to here, you have to spend one gold.
Yep. And so then we will resolve your obstacle. Or did you only do one of your companions?
No, the other one's gold.
Okay, so you are in the yellow region, so we will then suffer your foul fate. Deserters, place one foul fate in your region or fight a battle. Do you want to fight a battle?
Sure.
All right, so you're going to roll this yellow die and these white ones. And you're looking for two swords. Yep, that's the wrong one. Sorry about that.
Okay.
So, for the sake of the demo, I did start everybody off with stuff that's supposed to help, so.
You don't spend one day.
There you go. So then you have, you do not have to suffer. There you go. And now it's Geralt's turn again.
Huzzah. I will travel.
All right, and you are going to get a red leaf.
So I have...
immediately turn that in for one of these.
Which I assume is probably a good idea.
Yep. There you go. And what would you like to do? Oh.
Is my medallion refreshed now?
Yep.
Okay. And I will... see, and I'm going to be attacked by something, or there's a monster here?
There's a monster.
Oh, yeah. I will choose to develop.
All right, draw two, pick one.
Blizzard potion. And I now have to fight a monster?
Yes. you are fighting a Nilfgaard. You need three swords and two shields to defeat it. Before rolling, I will advance the war track, which means I spawn a Final Fate in your area. I don't have to resolve it yet, though.
All right. So I can spend one of these to...
As success.
Produce a...
Success. That is a Witcher sign.
Okay. And I can spend a Witcher sign to produce, to double my attack?
Yep.
I will do that then.
So you double your attack, which is still not quite enough. You don't have enough
what
shields
is the
either.
And?
That is another success. That is a success symbol.
But not. But I don't need successes right now. I need attack and defense.
Yep.
So I'll re-roll my hero dice.
Yep. And unfortunately, that you failed to defeat this monster. What that means is you suffer one wound. So how wounds work is they go in place of your character icon. So they then sit here, and you cannot perform that action until you heal.
Okay. Can I choose which one I put it on?
Yep.
We'll go on that one then. Okay.
All right.
So I don't have to do the deal with the foul fate then?
No.
Okay.
That would just be too bad.
Too many bad things at once. All right. And we would like a... I know what color that is. That's blue. It's just red and green. These are not even... Right. Okay.
And I'll develop.
Draw two, pick one.
So does he have to fight the monster? And the foul fate?
He has the option of picking which one. So if he decides to fight the monster, which I'm going to not recommend, and he can just suffer the foul fate. Probably suffer the foul fate.
Okay.
Alright, I mean, like, you have, unless you got a spell that you can't even, when a spell comes into play, they immediately get common markers on them. So what's that one?
One.
Alright. Unless it can, like, immediately spawn three swords.
Two swords and two shields.
You might be okay if you want to try and fight that. Because
try it.
You can, yeah. You want to give it a shot?
Yeah.
Alright. Roll that and your hero die.
But the hero die doesn't have any swords.
It doesn't, but it has a success thing, so it'll trigger.
Sword and shield.
So yeah, that's three and three. Alright, so... Does that kill it?
Yep.
Awesome. Alright, so... For succeeding,
good
you
work.
Get one victory point. And one point. So there you go. Woo. The blue for entering that location, you'll then also get additional blue, I believe, for our purple. I know what color these are, I swear.
I can turn this in now.
Yeah. And then you completed your task, which was to go to this location.
Yeah, so I receive one purple, and I draw one good fortune.
Alright, so the good fortune is... during your turn, you can play this card to receive two of the same color, or sorry, two leads of the same color. If you spend an additional coin, you receive one additional lead of the same color. So you can play that now.
Play that now?
Yes. You can play that now and get the...
Get two more purple?
Yep. And then
that's it?
Yep. So he now has everything he needs to complete his quest.
Yay.
So what do I do to... So can I complete it?
You have to return to Oxenford. Yep. So, I believe, though, that concludes your...
That was my travel.
Yep, and you cannot travel again.
Right. So I will... And there's going to be something I have to face there, right?
Yes.
So I will develop.
Okay, draw two, pick one.
Thank you.
Shadowrun demo agent.
Huh?
I'm a Shadowrun demo agent, so I understand.
Is this like a point where I'm just like, then I'm just gonna wait and then think about the ceiling? I guess.
32 hours of Shadowrun.
I really like this game. I mean, like, I'm having a good time, like, pretending to sort of not, like the, like, Descent Overlord, essentially, where I'm like, I've decided that this is what's going to happen now.
So what does this do?
So what this means is, once per turn, you may spend a common marker to move from this card to remove one foul fate from your hero sheet to cause another hero in your region to suffer a foul fate. So basically, you are transferring your bad luck to someone else. Yep.
Bend this wall to put a...
Yep. Alright. And that concludes your turn. You can either suffer a foul fate or you can fight a monster.
Yep.
The monster requires 3 swords and 2 shields. You're not terribly good at fighting.
No, I'm not. Can I use this to...
I don't think you can... I think it's once per battle, or how does it say?
Once per turn, you may spend one marker to, from this card, remove one foul fate from your hero sheet to cause another hero in your region to suffer.
Right, so if it's on your sheet, that's not the one that's up here.
Got it, all right. All right, then we'll do the foul fate. All
right. A unfortunate accident, so suffer one wound. So you place that on the hearts on your sheet, and then you will not be able to run that action until you, that is completed. Until you heal.
What is it? This thing gets me 2 gold, right?
Yeah. Okay. For each one, right?
Yep.
And you have 2?
Yep. And then I will travel over to here to get another red.
All right. There you go.
And that is that. All so.
Right. So you can either... You suffered a foul fate, right?
Huh?
You suffered the foul fate. That's what he did.
He did, I think.
You also
I did one.
Because you're in the same silver tandem and I just didn't take off. So you're going to fight this guy. Like, I think again. So you're going to roll the 6 die. And you're shooting for...
And I'll again double my attacks.
Why am I here?
I think you traveled and then got here.
Because you want to go to Oxford.
Because you want to get back to Oxford. I'm
trying to get back to Oxford
to turn in.
Sword. I think I got him, because I doubled my swords.
Okay, and it is enough shield as well, so good to go. There you go. And for killing him, you get 1 victory.
So, So what are victory points in this?
Victory points are ultimately how you really score at the end of the game. You're trying to complete quests only for the sake of the demo, but like the end of the game isn't triggered until you complete 3 quests. So
okay.
You still score victory points, but it's you do that after you score quests.
So is this cooperative, or is there like one winner at the end?
There is one winner at the end.
Okay.
So.
Gotcha.
Yep. There are support quests that you can also do that help, but for the sake of the demo, I don't really go into them. You help another player by giving them 6 victory points, and you get 3 in return, and that those are on every quest.
Hmm. Okay.
Side quests as well, you would get victory points doing that as well.
Gotcha.
So you defeat your monster, which means it's Triss's turn.
I will travel
to...
Let's investigate.
Great. Investigate. Task, go to Sintra. Receive 2 blue and 1 good fortune card. Keep this card for its strength. So it's like a separate task. So you gotta go to Sintra to complete your quest. Anyway, it's about to go. Alright. And then you are in the yellow region, which means you're gonna have to fight a silver monster, and that one is really hard. So you are going to have to roll 3 swords and 2 shields. Before rolling, everyone in the region loses a coin. So unfortunately, I believe you and Yarvin are going to lose coins. Is there a band of thieves? Alright, so you are going... Hopefully you have some things charged so that you can... Or unless you have something that can ignore a monster in the region.
Yeah, that's what I...
Alright. Would you like to do that?
Yep.
Okay, so...
So it's still there.
So it's still there, so you're just ignoring it for this turn. Alright. Which means that you guys...
Well, that's it. I like so much because they can do the task and the man, the druid, and they seem like the most powerful.
And I'm going to get distracted. Now you know that it sucks. But I think you would have to say that you didn't want to fight it and then use it so they wouldn't know, so that it wouldn't take everyone's money. If that's okay. Alright, so now it's Dandelion's turn again. So you're going to move to Oxenfurt and turn in your quest. Alright, so that is the extent of the demo, because it's until you complete this first quest. You can get a rough idea of how the turns tend to go, and that's a really rough overview of how to play things.
Great.
Do you guys have any questions?
Play cross.